الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة
Fear Allah that create you from one soul and create from it its spouse and spread all over a male and female from them and fear Allah and the kinship.
ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله
sure, the most هدي محمد truthful of speech is the book of Allah and the best guidance is the guidance of his messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and the most evil of affairs are innovations in religion and every innovation in is a bid'ah and every bid'ah is a misguidance and every misguidance will be in the fire.
أيها المسلمون
O Muslims, in the past,
in
previous lectures, we have mentioned that the Muslim
passes
in this life through different stages, which is the status of testing and the harsh time and the case of the bounties and then the third ones is the obedience when he obeyed Allah and the fourth one is when he commits sins and Allah did guide us in all of those four stages or cases to worship him and to face those challenges. We mentioned, or the Sheikh mentioned in previous lectures, in the stage of the harsh time, the Muslim has to experience and to execute the patience. And when he been blessed with a lot of bounties, he should worship Allah by thanking him for those bounties. And in the scenario of obedience, he should worship Allah by being sincere in his worship. And the last one, when there he is committing any mistakes or sins, he should worship Allah by making repentance to him and go back to the right path. So today we'll elaborate about the third scenario, which is when Allah bless you with full of bounties. And sorry, when Allah Azza wa Jal guided you to do the right things, this is a blessing from Allah that He guided you to do and to perform the right things. And to thank Allah for this, we know that when you follow the path of Allah Azza wa Jal, you'll find in your heart a sweetness of this iman, of this belief. Exactly when you taste a sweet food, exactly the same things the heart of the Muslim when he is in the right path, he will taste the sweetness of iman, of the faith in his heart. We know that obeying Allah Azza wa Jal, it may associated with some physical harshness or some duties that you have to perform. Human being by nature like the wealth, like to be everything convenient for him. However, the Muslim, if he sacrificed for the sake of Allah, his time, his money, his effort, you may temporarily feel some weaknesses, some hard time while you're doing this. However, it's just temporary. It will followed by infinite feeling of satisfaction and happiness in this life and in the hereafter. In the contrary, those who commit sins, they might find pleasure by doing those sins, and this is temporary. However, in the long run, this is going to become a pain in his heart. It's going to become a harsh time for him in this life and in the hereafter. So obedience to Allah, worshiping him, and being in his right path will bring satisfaction to the heart of the Muslims. That also will bring the satisfaction that Allah Azza wa Jal will like his abd. There's a lot of fruits that as a result of worshipping Allah and following His path, it's countless. We're not going to be able to count those ones in this short time or short lecture. It's summarized by following what Allah Azza wa Jal, He asked us to follow and to forbid and refrain from doing the things that Allah Azza wa Jal asked us to be away from. Allah did show us in different verses in the Quran that whoever fear Allah and follow His path, Allah will make things much more smooth to him, and Allah will protect him, and Allah will make things are smooth in different verses of the Quran. And whoever fear Allah, Allah will forgive his sins and he will increase his rewards. And fearing Allah, it's the reason that you can capture the knowledge, that you can benefit yourself and your community from it. When Allah said, and fear Allah, and Allah will teach you, will grant you the knowledge. And if you look closely, each good deed, each good worship will have its own benefits. For example, if you make repentance and make istighfar, this is going to be a reason that Allah will increase your wealth and increase your offsprings, your children, your money, will give you the bounties in your wealth and the blessing. Prayer, it's the connection between the slave and his God. You name it, the fasting, any good deed, any good ta'a, by itself it has its own blessing and bounties. Abdullah bin Abbas, may Allah be pleased upon him, he said, each good ta'a you do it, you'll find a light in your heart, in your face, and you will find it. You'll find also you're gonna expand and your rizq, and the people will like you. All those are the fruits of those kind of things. Those are signs of that you're going to enjoy if you follow the right things and do the right things. And you become very sensitive when you see bad things or sins. Your filter sensitivity will be high. Allah will give you the blessing and the bounties. The people will like you. All of those are fruits of following the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. So this third scenario, when you are in a status of obedience for Allah Azza wa Jal, it's great status, it's a great scenario. In this scenario, Allah Azza wa Jal told us we should worship Him with sincerity. Sincerity in Arabic, it means when you purify the thing from all elements, so it's become purified. This is the language meaning. Al-Ikhlas, and the fiqh ma'na, meaning of it, that the worship that you perform from praying, from pilgrims, from umrah, from helping the needy, you name it, has to be sincere. purified.
الأعمال الصالحة التي يحبها الله ويرضاها، الدعوة إلى الله تعالى،
asking people to do the right things, you name it, all the good deeds.
ظاهرة بشيء من سنن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Following the sunnah of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام in the way you look, in the way you wear, all of those things need a sincerity. You do it for the sake of Allah only, and it's purified from all mistakes. Meaning that you do it just only for the sake of Allah. You don't give. You don't care about other things.
One of the things that contradict
with the sincerity in your worship, if you worship somebody along, you worship with Allah. This is a kufr, this is a shirk. This is against and interdict with the meaning of sincerity. Also riya, hypocrisy. When you do something and you expect people to praise you in this action, this is again contradict with sincerity. And if you are proud of yourself, this is also in the bad one. That's also contradict when you are proud of yourself, of your deeds, and you think you are supreme, and you look to the others as if you are better than them. That's gonna lead to that you say you're looking for their rumors from reputation, and this is also against the sincerity. And here it's a delicate issue. When you do this kind of things and you do it for the purpose that the people will praise you, nobody knows what in your heart except Allah. Allah knows what in your heart. And if you do all those kind of things, it's again contradict with sincerity. You do it for the sake of people who praise you.
السمعه
in Arabic, the reputation is if you do something and not in the public, however you go and you publicize it, you talk to the people, I did this and that and this and that, so the people know a good deed that he did it. Also, this is contradict with the sincerity for Allah Azza wa Jal. This is seeking the sum'ah, seeking the reputation. Again, this is contradict with the sincerity. Because sometimes when you mention those kind of things to somebody that will help him, now if you also say that I did this and that to somebody that you help him, this is called al-man, and again this is also contradict with the sincerity in your worshiping, in your good deeds. So that's what we call al-man in Arabic, that you recalling the person that you helped him, that you did a good deed for him. Allah said, O who believe, do not cancel your sadaqat by al-man wal-adha, as those who spend their money for the sake of the people and they don't care about the if this is accepted from Allah or not. And then Allah invoke an example like a rock that has over it some sand. So there's a water, it was raining, and that raining hit that rock and removed the sand over it and lifted and show it as if the truth of that rock. And left it without any sand over it. Exactly, this is the example of those who make the man mannan. So he did a good deed, however he went outside and started saying, I did this and this and that. So the water resembled the fact that it removed all the sand over the rock and the only things remain is the rock. Exactly, he won't get any reward for his good deeds. We ask Allah to benefit us from what we have said, and we make repentance for all.
Alhamdulillah.
all praises to Allah and
ومن اتبع هديه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فإن الإخلاص لله سبحانه وتعالى
في
الطاعة وفي الأعمال الصالحة هو روح
This is the soul of the work, of the worship, of the deeds. A work without sincerity is exactly like a body without soul. It's like a tree without roots. Or a tree without fruits. So you see the skeleton of the good the deeds, but it has no value. So sincerity is the most important thing. It's the soul of the deed. It's the real fruit that will benefit and reward whoever did that work in this life and in the hereafter. Because when you do any, you perform any good deed, you ask and for the sake of Allah, Allah knows that and Allah will reward you for that. However, if you did something for the sake of the people, they're not going to benefit you. They're not going to reward you. The Prophet ﷺ warned us from a riya, being happy, saying that whoever purposely intended to show the people that he did a good deed, so they praise him, Allah in the day of the judgment, and Allah will make sure that the people will see some bad things from him. And whoever intend to make sure that the people listen to the things, the good deeds that he done, Allah will make sure the people will listen bad things about him. Simply a fair response to his action. The scholars and the companions used to seek to hide their good deeds, exactly like each one tried to hide a bad deed. Exactly like we tried to hide a bad deed. Those good people used to do their best to hide their good deeds. The Sheikh giving an example, if they would use to recite the Quran, and if somebody knocked the door in his home, he would cover the Mus'haf, the Quran, so people don't think that really he is, you know, trying to be hypocrite or trying to do good deeds, because their deeds were sincere for Allah only. Even those who used to teach the people, if he fears some, if he get emotional about ayah in the Quran or hadith, he would try to make as if he has a cold, so the people do not praise him because he get emotional from that verse. So the goal is, or the bottom line is, they were trying to hide their good deeds.
يعني كتمتها كلما يعني ظهرت بصورة يعني أكبر.
And the benefit of it, the more you do it sincerely for Allah, the more you try to hide it, the more rewards you're gonna get. And the Sheikh is revoking a kind of perfume the Arab use. It's called al-oud. The more you hide it, the more you're trying to control its smell, the bitter and the stronger the smell will become. So the more you be sincere, seeking in your deeds, the goal of Allah, the sake of Allah, Allah will show the good part of you for the people, even if you try to hide these things. O Muslims, doing sincere things, there's a lot of fruit being mentioned in the Quran, in the Sunnah as well. Some of it,
it's
It's first of all, it's the mandatory pillar to accept the good deed. The good deed won't be accepted unless is it sincere and correct. Correct meaning it's follow the right path, the Sunnah of the Prophet. and should not be a bid'ah innovation, should not be against the Sharia al-Islam, against the teaching of the Prophet, and it should be allowable, not forbidden, and it should follow the path of the Prophet, and it should be sincere, and you done it only for the sake of Allah.
عملا يخالف يعني فيه شيء من البدعة أو المخالفة أو كذا إذا كان خالص النية هو يعني وصدق النية.
Even the scholar say that if somebody did something not because he due to the lack of knowledge, however he was sincere, however even if he commit bid'ah, commit innovation, however the reason he committed because lack of knowledge, however his sake and deep inside he is sincere that he done it for Allah Azza wa Jal, Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah said he will be rewarded in his intention. He will reward it for the sake that he did it for sincerity. However, he's not gonna be rewarded for the deed itself, because the deed again is correct, incorrect. There's a bid'ah, there's innovation. However, he intended to do good things. However, he didn't follow the right path. So, inshallah, he will be rewarded for being sincere. Allah will reward him for that. However, he won't accept his deed, because as we said, if his deed is innovation or
bid'ah.
And also, when you're sincere in your deeds to Allah, it's gonna pay you back in the harsh time. Allah Azza wa Jal will save it for you, and there's a lot of example in the book of the Quran. Allah mentioned that non-believers used when they ride the seas, they would do the supplication very sincerely once the waves become when they afraid of they're going to be soaking in the sea, they would make a supplication sincerely so they get back safely to the shore, and Allah Azza wa Jal would save them because of their sincere supplication. However, when they reach the safe shore, then they would say, because Allah and the things they used to worship, we won't be able to make it for the shore, the safe shore. Allah then revealed those verses talking about those things. So Azza wa Jal would save them because they're sincere in their supplication. And they are non-believers, and Allah knows what in their hearts.
The Prophet Yusuf,
when he was in the
لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء إنه من عبادنا المخلصين.
Allah praise Yusuf عليه السلام. He said that he saved him when he was in the scenario with the lady of the Aziz.
المخلصين كل موضع في القرآن فيه المخلصين يقرؤونه المخلصين في عدد من القراءات المتواترة.
And there's different narration for recitation for the Quran.
And المخلص هو المخلص في الحقيقة لأن القراءات which is
trying to the major point here is Yusuf عليه السلام, he was sincere and that's how Allah protect him from committing the sin with that lady.
كل موضع فيه المخلصين الذين اختارهم الله هم أيضا المخلصون الذين أخلصوا لله سبحانه وتعالى لذلك الإخلاص هو
so
السبيل
sincerity is the way, يعني is the vehicle, so Allah will choose you and you become from those who are sincere. Allah protect Yusuf because that fact
ثبته الله تعالى.
Allah remove the bad things from him. If you look to the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, the story of those the cave, Surah Al-Kahf,
البخاري ومسلم وغيرهم. فذكر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثلاثة نفر من من كانوا قبلنا من الأمم السابقة وأنهم رواهم المبيت إلى غار.
They were traveling and there was the night came and they went to protect themselves in, inside a cave in a mountain.
So
they went through it. And however, a big rock rolled down and closed the opening of that cave. And then they said, nothing will save you unless you make supplication to Allah with the good deeds that you done in the past. And they know, those were before us, before the Muslims. However, they know from the Sharia of the Prophet at that time. Each one from them mentioned a good deed that he'd done it for the sake of Allah and he was sincere. And then after he said that, oh Allah, if I did it for your sake, may Allah open up and save us and let us go out from this cave. And it's the first one started, the rock moved a little bit, and the second also he made the supplication and the rock moved a little bit more, and the third come and he make the supplication, and then they could even by Allah Azza wa Jal, and they went outside from that cave. The first one mentioned about how he used to be pious with his parents. He would come in the night holding the milk, and he would not give it to anyone except before he gave it to his parents. His habit was to give it to his parents first and then to his kids and his wife. And one night he came a little bit late and he found his parents are already slept. So he stand holding the milk next to their foot, waiting to them till they woke up. And his kids won't give to his kids till his parents woke up. And then those who interpret the hadith, he said, if you know, his kids were really.
يعني قد يكون مرجوحا او كذا انه لا تعارض بين بر الوالدين ويسقي الاطفال.
The scholar said, I mean, there's no contradiction. He should give some kids and keep for his parents. Nothing wrong with that. However, what helped him in that scenario is his sincere for his piousness with his parents. The second one mentioned that there was a cousin for him. He was commit adultery. However, she in one day, and he did not done it. One day, she asked him for money, and she couldn't return back the money back to him, and she agreed so he can commit that. However, when he wanna pursue that, she mentioned to him, fear Allah and don't do this sins.
So,
and then he feared Allah Azza wa Jal and he left her. And he didn't even ask her for the money.
تعفف عن الزنا خوفا من الله تعالى رغم أنه يعني وقع في مقدمات الزنا وكذا ولا يعني وأساء بهذا لكن امتناعه وخوفه
so
من الله تعالى.
So restraining from committing that sin, his feeling from Allah, he was sincere, and you know Allah also helped him out by removing some part of the rock from that, the opening of the cave. The third one, the last one, he mentioned that he used to have a worker that he worked for him, and he wanted to give him his money for the hours that he works for him. That person looked to it and he did not like that amount, and he said he refused to take it because it's not too much. So, and he refused to take it and he left him. Then that person, the job owner, invest in that money, and even he has a huge cattle that can, you know, years passed and this worker come back to that person, to the job, to the employer. He told him that I worked in the past in you for one day and you did not give me my money. He told him I came back and I need my money. He told him, well, look to those cattle. It's all for you. The employee thought that he is making a mistake of him. He said, fear Allah and don't joke on me. I need just my money. He told me, it's indeed yours, so take it, and this is for you. So he indeed took all the cattle with him. So he was sincere in that when that guy refused to take the money. And so the reason we invoke this story is that because they were sincere in their good deeds, Allah Azza wa Jal saved them from that harsh time.
فإن العمل القليل إذا أخلص فيه الإنسان بارك الله تعالى فيه.
And we know in the day of judgment, if you do even a small amount of good deeds that are sincere, Allah Azza wa Jal will double and triple and multiple the reward in the day of judgment. Even the word, the statement لا إله إلا الله, if you say it sincerely from your heart, the reward is tremendous. You cannot count it. The well-known story that a person, there's different narration for the same story, that a person who found a dog that almost kind of died from thirst. He was very thirsty and he could not reach a water. There was a well and he could not reach the water from it. That person and another narration, a lady, so they took their shoes and they went down and filled their shoes with water and gave it to the dog, and Allah forgive all his sins for that lady or that person, simply because even if that person or that lady was committing sins, she was sincere. Nobody looking to her, nobody know what she's doing, however she really was sincere in that deed. So sincerity in the deed, when you are sincere in whatever you perform, the rewards are great and tremendous. It doesn't matter how big the worship, how big the good deed is. If you are sincere, Allah will multiply the reward regardless the size of that work. May Allah make us from those who are sincere and forgive our sins. The Sheikh is making dua.
وأصلح لنا آخرتنا التي فيها معادنا واجعل الحياة زيادة لنا في كل خير واجعل الموت راحة لنا من كل شر. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك ومن تحول عافيتك ومن فجاءة نقمتك ومن جميع سخطك. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عن من سواك. اللهم آمين. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة.